What is good, YouTube world? It's Jay Coffee Talk. Tapping back in with another one, guys. We got a lot of news to cover. Some NFL news, some hip-hop news, a very bizarre, tragic story. I don't even know what to make of it. Y'all, let me know what you think in the comments, man. But first up, you see the footage here. Wild play in this Minnesota Green Bay Packers NFC North rivalry matchup. This is being dubbed the Immaculate Reception 2.0. as you see, it's crazy, like the pass is deflected and just almost looks like another real live Madden glitch. We've been seeing that a lot lately, man. What's going on, guys? Is there a glitch in the matrix? Is the simulation fucking up or something? What's going on? But the center ends up catching the pass. As you know, typically offensive line is not eligible to catch a pass unless the guy on the end, you know, has checked in as a receiver on like a trick play type ish. But when the ball is tipped, it's a free for all. Anyone can grab that thing, and the center ends up picking up, what's it look like, 15, 20 yards or something. Bradbury got there. Pretty wild the way it happened. Immaculate Reception 2.0, I guess. But the result of the play and what was at stake and everything, it totally different than the original Immaculate Reception, I guess, was still a hell of a play. Let me know what y'all think in the comments. Then next up, man, all the talk that's been going on about Jay-Z ever since that Twitter Spaces live conversation he was having with Alicia Keys, the comments he made about, you know, no one could see him on that stage, that versus stage. Everyone was talking about M versus Jay. I've been saying Nas versus Jay is what really makes sense, but at the end of the day, I don't think we'll really get Jay in a versus. I don't think he really has any interest in it, but you know, everyone still is enjoying debating on this. And Kodak Black jumps into the conversation. As you see this tweet he threw up, he said, "I'll do a versus with Jay-Z if," in quotes he puts, "if he win, he gets 15% of my catalog. I win, he makes me vice president of Rock Nation." So some interesting stakes there from Kodak Black. I don't know, like, you know, Jay-Z, for some reason, Kodak throwing that out there. Like I just said, Jay has no interest in doing the verses, but Kodak throwing that out there, those kind of stipulations, 15% of the catalog versus a vice presidency at Rock Nation, it kind of feels to me like something Hove would be interested in. You know what I mean? Like sometimes if you're speaking someone's language, you can kind of draw them in to tap into what you're saying. What Kodak did there, I think, was kind of smart. I don't know. I feel like that's something Jay-Z would be like, "Oh, this guy's a thinker. I like the way he thinks." But who knows? You know, we probably still won't see it. But anyways, I want to know what y'all think about this Kodak Black. Jay-Z, hit the comments. Then we got Randy Orton getting in on the fun, the meme fun regarding the viral situation that happened during the Jets Tampa Bay Buccaneers AB Antonio Brown. Like, we've been talking about this for days. We saw his driver yesterday, Danny Hustlehard. That dude's a fool, man. That was some funny ish but you see Randy Orton snatch this little freeze frame of AB, and he says he inspired that out of AB, right? He said he sees one Randy Orton match and he bite my swag, you know what I mean? I thought this was rather funny. But still, you know, with all the developments, what is everyone thinking of the AB situation? Obviously, we've been discussing this since it happened. There's some new stuff out there where people are saying, you know, AB was injured and didn't want to go out there. You know, he could potentially sue the Buccaneers for wrongful termination. I don't know. I'm still sticking to that. I think this was all some big publicity stunt that he went into that game knowing he was going to do that. Like the fact that he drops that super gremlin tweet and then drops some music right after. I don't know. I feel like there's something behind that. Other people are seeing it different ways. Let me know what you think. And then last up, man, is this sad, tragic news I was talking about. This is absolutely crazy, man. This dude, Christopher De La Cruz, 28 years old, lost his life in New York City in the subway trying to jump the turnstile. Now, obviously, I can't share the footage with y'all. You know what I'm saying? That joint would get flagged in a second. But I got the link pinned below in the comments. And what's going on here is this dude was in the subway late night, like 1-2 a.m. swasted, you know what I mean, saucy, lost in the sauce, stumbling around and everything, and was trying to jump the turnstile, just didn't have his legs under him, you know what I mean, like he's really drunk, like where this man really couldn't walk, you know what I'm saying, like we've all had our, like, an RIP to this dude. I'm not trying to clown him, it is what it is, he lost his life, but like we've all had our moments when we're drunk, I'm sure. Comment if you can relate, where you've made an ass of yourself, or you said or did something like you're like ashamed of, or whatever the case may be. But just hearing this, that this dude jumped trying to jump the turnstile, sounds like outrageous. But if you see the footage, once again, link pinned below in the comments. I can't share it in the video, you know what I mean? You could see that this dude really could not walk. That's how drunk he was. And he tries to hop the turnstile a couple times. He ends up losing his phone. His phone slides all out there. And then, you know, he makes one more attempt and just comes down head first and broke his neck, man. He was found just unconscious, deceased, head first, lost his life, 28 years old. Over a $2.75 fare. It's absolutely crazy, man. Like, it's just so bizarre. I mean, because when I heard this, I was like, come on, that can't be that hard to jump the turnstile. This don't add up. But then, like I said, when you see how he was moving around, extremely intoxicated, there you have it, you know. So jump in the comments with your thoughts on all that. Once again, the footage, links pinned in the comments, but let's talk about it all, man. Immaculate Reception 2.0, Randy Orton, AB, Jay-Z, Kodak, let's bust it all down in the comments. Make sure to sub to the channel, stay tuned, daily content dropping, music, news, sports, and more. It's Coffee signing out. Peace.